Fire operations in Alaska are managed under the Alaska Interagency Wildland Fire Management Plan, or AIWFMP. Within the plan, broad objectives and standard responses described as management options are assigned by jurisdictional agencies to their lands pre-season. During an incident, the interagency plan is used in conjunction with unit fire management plans to develop the decision support documentation necessary to develop incident-specific strategic objectives and/or establishing the course of action for an incident. Protecting agencies are the lead agencies for implementing incident operational direction. The protecting agencies maintain operational control and provide supervision and logistical support of all wildfires. Incident commanders work directly for protection agencies. Roles and responsibilities of the jurisdictional and protecting agencies are detailed in the Alaska Interagency Wildland Fire Management Plan and in the Alaska Statewide Master Agreement. The Interagency Fire Plan, the Master Agreement, as well as management option maps are all available on the Alaska Interagency Coordination Center website. Wildland fire management options have been defined to provide a range of responses from suppression actions that restrict the size and extent of a fire to periodic monitoring of fire behavior to enable a natural fire regime. Management options also provide a method of prioritization for assigning firefighting resources. The primary objective of all management option areas is public and firefighter safety. The four management options are critical, full, modified, and limited. The critical fire management options, shown here in red, are the highest priority areas and sites for suppression actions and assignment of available firefighting resources. Lands in the wildland-urban interface and other populated areas where there is an immediate threat to human life, primary residences, inhabited property, community-dependent infrastructure, and structural resources designated as National Historic Landmarks qualify to be considered this designation. This classification may apply to an entire village or town, as well as a single inhabited structure. The full option areas and sites, shown here in orange, objectives include control of all wildland fires at the smallest reasonable size and to protect high-value natural resource areas. Native allotments are designated full or critical. Developed recreation facilities or administrative sites may also be designated full. Each agency has a structure or site protection policy, and it varies between agencies. The modified management option, shown here in yellow, provides a management level between full and limited. The intent is to balance acres burned with suppression costs and to accomplish land and resource management objectives when conditions are favorable. Early in the Alaska fire season, the modified option is treated as full. A conversion to limited may happen mid-July or later, dependent upon fire potential. Site-specific actions are taken as warranted. The limited management option, shown here in green, is designed for broad landscape scale areas where low density and wide distribution of values to be protected best allows for fire to function in its ecological role. Sites that warrant higher levels of protection may occur within the boundaries of limited areas, and actions to protect these sites will be taken when warranted without compromising the intent of this management option. Non-sensitive sites do not require any type of protection, suppression actions, or considerations. The Alaska Interagency Wildland Fire Management Plan provides a consistent, cost-effective interagency approach to wildland fire management and is supported by the collaborative efforts of the Department of Interior agencies, U.S. Forest Service, the State of Alaska, and Alaska Native organizations.